To time a grace, I just noticed how ghetto I am. I just stick tissues in my nose and it stops. Hey guys, you're probably here because you want to know all about scabies and its treatments, and I'm going to answer that question along with many other questions in this week's Responding to Your Comments, where we look at fun questions, we look at science-based questions, but most importantly, we look at the evidence. Lana B, dude, I think I have scabies. What do I do? Lana B, thank you for your comment. This is from the How to Get Rid of Dandruff video. For those of you who don't know what scabies is, it's a very, very itchy skin infestation caused by tiny mites. They're actually so tiny that you can't see them with the naked eye. You can only see them with a microscope. And they're spread by close contact, so either living with someone or sharing a bed with someone. So my first bit of advice for anyone who thinks they might have scabies is speak to your healthcare professional. And the reason I'm saying this is that scabies can be quite difficult to diagnose, and as with all skin conditions, they all have many similarities. So you need to speak to your healthcare professional so that they can examine you and ask the right questions to come up with a diagnosis. Now your next question probably is, well, what are the symptoms of scabies? And now I'm gonna go into them for you. So firstly, we have intense itching, especially at night time. And secondly, we have something called linear burrows. So linear means a straight line, burrows means tunnels, and this is where the mite lay their eggs. And they're usually about 2 to 10 millimeters in length. Their appearance is silverish and they have a dot on one end, and they're usually found on the fingers or on the wrist. You can then develop a rash, and this can pretty much develop anywhere, but it's usually in the fingers. The only place it won't really develop is on the head, and this rash can then slowly turn into little tiny red spots. So as you can see, the symptoms of scabies, well, with skin conditions, they all share a lot of symptoms, so it can be quite difficult to diagnose, which is why I'm saying you really need to speak to a healthcare professional so they can come up with a diagnosis and ask you all the right questions. In addition to this, the NHS has a really useful page on scabies, talking about all the symptoms, and also it's got some really good images on there, so I will leave a link in the description below if you want more information on this. So that's a little about the symptoms, but what about treatments? Because scabies is something that definitely needs treating, but please don't think to yourself, oh, well, I've been prescribed this cream and it's done the trick, because there's a lot more things that you need to do to prevent them from coming back, and I'm going to be going into lots of detail about that in this video. Now, if it's just normal scabies and not crusted scabies, generally speaking in the UK, the first line treatment is permethrin 5% cream, and this will be recommended to you either by your pharmacist or your doctor when you speak to them about your scabies, but always check with them that you're safe and suitable to use it, and also always read the information leaflet that comes with that medication so you know how to use it correctly, because a lot of this treatment, the effectiveness of it comes down to how you're using it, so you need to use it correctly for the best outcome. Generally speaking, you will have to reapply it again after a week, so the first time you've used it, reapply again after a week, but in the information leaflet it will explain how to do this properly, so please read the information leaflet. And just a quick tip, if your doctor has prescribed your child or your baby some treatment, like let's say the permethrin, it's also a good idea to put some socks or some mittens on their hands. This is to prevent them from either wiping it off or licking it off, so the treatment can stay on there for as long as possible for the best effect. Now please remember that scabies is very infectious, and it can actually take up to 8 weeks for the symptoms to appear. So what does this mean? Well, it means that many people who are close to you are going to need treating too. So for example, anyone that lives with you in the same household, any close personal contact, and any sexual partners that you've had in the past 2 months, all of these people will need treating as well. Next up, we have bedding, clothes, and towels. On the first day of treatment, all of these will need decontaminating as well. So how do you decontaminate? Well, it's pretty easy. You put them in the wash on a really high temperature wash, 60 degrees Celsius, and then dry them in a hot dryer. For clothes or anything that can't be washed, like they're very delicate, you can put them in a sealed plastic bag for 72 hours. Please remember also, all the people that we just mentioned who also need treating, they need to do this as well. And to stop scabies from spreading, please do not have sex or close physical contact with anyone until you have finished a full course of treatment. Also, please do not share bedding, clothing, or towels with anyone who has scabies. Now, a common question that I do get asked by many patients is, how long does it take for the scabies treatment to work? And what I can tell you is, after you've used the first course of treatment, you or your child can go back to work or back to school after 24 hours. So once you've applied the first course of treatment, give it 24 hours and then you can go back to school or back to work. This is completely fine. You may still have symptoms. This is quite normal. So the itchiness is quite normal to have for a couple of weeks afterwards. But if it does last for 4 weeks or more, then please make an appointment to speak to your doctor and have a follow-up. I really hope my tips help anyone who's watching this video. And as always, I will leave more information in the description below. I'll also leave some really useful NHS links to articles about scabies, its treatments, its prevention, interventions, so check them out as well. And now let's move on to the next question. Two-timer Grace, I just noticed how ghetto I am. I just stick tissues in my nose and it stops. Two-timer Grace, thank you for your comment. This is from the How to Stop a Runny Nose video. And to be honest, two-timer, I don't think you're ghetto. I've done it. I'm pretty sure everyone's done that before when they've got a runny nose and it didn't know what to do with it, and you just end up sticking loads of tissues in there. But obviously, my video has now taught you guys what to do, so I hope my tips help, and always remember you're awesome. Dairy Joy Son, imagine him as the father of your baby. You won't need to worry, lol. Thanks for the tips though, this will help my baby nephew. Thank you for your comment, this is from the How to Get Rid of Nappy Rash video. And yeah, that's a really lovely comment, but I promise you, I'm really not too good with children. I mean, I know about ailments and conditions and treatments, but overall, I'm not one of those people that's very good with kids. You know, you have some people that kids like love and they're like really happy with, but for some strange reason, they always cry when I come. I think it's because I'm really tall. Peaches Kong, lol at your colleague at the door waiting to come in. Peaches Kong, thank you for your comment. This is from the Nappy Rash video. And yes, I've said it before, I will say it again. People that watch YouTube have such a high attention to detail. And you know, I think you're probably one of the first people that's noticed that actually, which is quite unusual because people usually notice things very quickly on YouTube. But if you haven't seen it, let's have a quick look and have a quick laugh.
Which leads me on to tip number two, clean the nappy area thoroughly and gently. Either use water or use alcohol and fragrance-free wipes.
So it looks like we've run out of time again in this week's responding to your comments. If I didn't answer your question, I'm really sorry, but the best advice I can give you is leave another comment. We are getting so many comments nowadays that it's quite easy to miss it. So the best advice I can give is keep on leaving comments and it will catch my eye, it will catch my attention, and I will include it in a future episode of responding to your comments. Always remember you're awesome and I will see you next week.
Hey guys, thanks for watching this week's video. Make sure to click that like, follow, or subscribe button now to stay up to date with new weekly videos.